Once again, the Kims are going on another adventure. And this time we're going to Yosemite.
But instead of driving the arduous 300 miles straight, we decided to break up the trip and stop for a night at my sister-in-law's place in Central California.
So we're finally here at my sister-in-law's place. And tomorrow, we're going to rest up tonight. Tomorrow I'm going to work from here. And then the next day after that, on Friday, is when we're heading off to Yosemite.
This is where we're all going to sleep.
We pretty much stayed indoors to avoid the brutal Central California heat, but the kids didn't mind. They were too busy playing video games. Thank you, Nintendo, for being our babysitter. You really saved me from pulling out all my hair.
5:52, and we are going to leave for Yosemite in 10 minutes. So we're about 2-3 hours from our campsite. So not too long of a drive, but all the kids are asleep right now. So we're gonna get them in the car.
But before leaving, we had to stop by our friend's donut shop. Our Cambodian friends have run this place for more than 10 years. And have previously purchased it from another friend of ours. I'm not sure how long it's actually been in operation, but it's pretty common for businesses like this to change ownership many times. The story of Cambodian-owned donut shops is in many ways the story of America, and it all starts with one man, Ted Ngoy. Him and his family touched down in Camp Pendleton in 1975, bearing refugee status from the brutal Khmer Rouge regime. In those days, the donut scene was a variable landscape of hit or miss mom and pop joints who weren't known for making the freshest products. Ngoy changed all that with his local chain, Christy's Donuts. He was the first Southeast Asian trainee for Winchel's, where he learned all the aspects of managing a store. After a year of hard work, he saved up the $20,000 to buy his first shop located in La Habra, California. With the help of extended family and a lean payroll, he was able to purchase 4 more shops in a year. And after 5 years, he had 20, leasing out his restaurant to newly arrived Cambodian refugees and giving them an entrepreneurial path. By the mid-90s, Cambodians owned over 2,400 donut shops, and Ngoy was almost singularly responsible for all of it. Fast forward to today, and the tradition of Cambodian-owned donut shops continues at Rocky's Donut. The locals appreciate the friendly customer service, and of course, they love the donuts. Here, Dylan's working the cash register, hopefully learning a thing or two about making cold hard cash. There's my brother-in-law putting in some sweat equity behind the scenes. Donuts are basically mixed dough that is dropped into hot oil, fried, then glazed. Some of them are filled with jam, which are called Bismarcks. Their dough can be raised in a chemical process, resulting in a denser cake-like texture, while yeast-raised donuts are lighter but take several hours to produce. Anyone could make these at home, but it would be hard to get the quality and texture that's been earned from years of experience. It's no wonder business is booming at Rocky's. Just look at all the patrons coming in. They can't wait to take a bite out of these tasty morsels.
So quick stop at Rocky's Donut in Lemoore before we head off to Yosemite. And the kids got a bunch of treats. You should let Dylan in first, Nolan. Tasty? Tastes good?
Thank you for watching. And if you enjoyed this video, here's some more suggestions. And as always, please like, subscribe, and press the bell for notifications. And I'll see you on the next Kim's Adventure.